I often get a lot of questions asking how do we choose between the three main classes of thin features that we have available. These are namely the thin extrude, the web, and the rib commands. To attempt to answer that question, I'm going to go through this example where we are going to create ribs in an enclosure using all three methods. The sidewalls were created by an arc, so we have a slight curvature going along this face. The box was first filleted on the outside and then shelved. So we have these curved inner faces here. Looking from the side, there is a taper along the whole length of the box. All these features will serve to stress test how well the ribs can conform to these inner faces. We will be judging the effectiveness of these features based on the following two criteria. First, the ability to conform to the inner faces of the box. Second, the patternability, how well the patterned instances adjust to the changing relief of the box. I will leave a link for you to download the starting model. For the first method, we shall try using a thin extrude. The ribs need to be slightly below the top face of the box, so we will need to have a construction plane below the top face. Perform a sketch on this plane. We will be drawing a line that spans the width of the box. In order to do that, the line needs to be anchored to the sides of the box. To create these anchor points, go to Create, Project Include, Intersect. If we hover over one of the side walls, we see a preview in red. This red line represents the intersection between the active sketch plane and the side walls. Select this face and the opposite face and confirm. Create a straight line that snaps to these two projected lines. Begin the extrude command and select the thin extrude option. Select the line as a profile. Change the operation to join. To extrude down to the bottom, we can change the extent type to all. This would extend the extrude all the way to the base. You can see that the extend to all option does a good job to conform to the bottom face without producing any excess. An alternative is to change the extend type to two object and select the base face as the object. Both these extend types produce the same result. Adjust the wall thickness and wall location. I'm going to exaggerate the thickness so that I can show you how a thin extrude works. Looking at the side walls of the rib, you can see that it does not conform to the side of the box. This is because the extrude thickens in a direction that is normal to the sketch line. So the side walls would not be able to conform to the curved inside walls of the box. It is possible to purposely draw the sketch line to be within the thickness of the walls, but this method is pretty arbitrary. Also, depending on the curvature of the walls, the rib thickness would be limited. Let's ignore this for the moment and see how well the thin feature patterns. I will perform a simple rectangular pattern with the compute option set to adjust. The patterned instances do a good job of conforming to the tapered base. However, the length of the rib stays the same as the original. So there are limitations when it comes to the thin extrude. For the next method, we will use the same sketch to perform a web. Go to Create, Web. Select the line as a profile. For extend type, select up to next. If the feature does not look right, you might need to flip the direction. Adjust the thickness. The feature conforms to both the sides and the base, leaving no gaps. As a side note, the web feature is also able to accept a line that does not extend all the way to the sides, so long as you check the Extend Curves option. Let's see how well the web feature copes with being patterned. Again, perform a rectangular pattern with Adjust as a compute option. The pattern's features conform to the sides and the base. For the next method, let's use the rib command. The rib feature is extruded in the direction normal to the sketch plane. So we will not be able to use the same sketch. We would have to perform the sketch on the plane offset from the right plane. Let's use the slice option to create a cross-sectional view cut by the sketch plane in order to see where we are drawing. Create a straight line. This does not have to extend all the way to the sides. The rib command would automatically extrapolate the line. Go to Create, Rib. Select the line as a profile. For extend type, set to next. Adjust the thickness. You might need to flip the direction if the feature does not look right. So we have achieved an identical result to the web command. Let's see how well this patterns. So we can conclude that both the rib and web commands are able to fulfill both our criteria, and both are superior to the thin extrude. So how do you choose between the two? In order to decide, we will need to look at the kind of ribs that we need to produce. If we need to produce a complicated pattern looking from the top, for example with lots of criss-crossing lines, it will make more sense to use the web command, as it will be easier to draw this sketch from the top. In this case, there is a non-linear sketch in the form of an arc. It will be impossible to achieve this sketch on the front plane. So we are limited to making this sketch on the top plane and using the web command. On the other hand, if we need the rib feature to be of a certain shape looking from the side, it will make more sense to use the rib feature. In this case, we can draw this shape on the right plane and let the rib feature do the rest.